Greetings, Eric Bakker from New Zealand, the naturopath from New Zealand. Question here from a man called Jeff Durham in NC, USA. NC, I'm not sure where that is. Jeff Durham. I know a Durham in America. In fact, I'm a beekeeper and I watch a guy called Tim Durham from Durham's Bees down in Mississippi. Are you from Mississippi, Jeff Durham? I'm not sure what NC means. It must be some state in America. Anyway, Jeff Durham is asking, Dr. Bakker, I've been working to heal leaky gut and all the bad symptoms that go with it for a year now, and it's only getting worse. I've had 8 silver amalgam fillings that I'm having replaced that I and my doctor and dentist think are keeping me from getting better. Mercury, I know now, can keep you from absorbing vital nutrients, including zinc, which causes urinary prostate issues that doctor treated with Supro antibiotic, which left me with leaky gut candida. When I'm done getting the amalgams removed, should I work on getting rid of the mercury left in my digestive tract or concentrate on treating the leaky gut first? Had 4 amalgam fillings replaced with more amalgams 2 years ago and health issues started 3 months later. Many of your readers may have been getting the same problem. Mercury from dental amalgam is keeping leaky gut from getting better. Your videos are most informative. Thank you, I'm Jeff Durham. Sorry about that, but it just reminds me of Tim Durham, a wonderful old man that I watch on YouTube, who's given me some sage advice on beekeeping. So, Jeff, I would probably recommend a hair analysis. There's main ways you can get a mercury analysis done, not just for mercury, but also for other metals. There's other sulfhydryl metals like lead. There's lead, then there's cadmium, and there's arsenic. These three metals have something in common. We call them sulfhydryl metals. So these metals actually bind quite well to different types of things that we can take in into the body. Thorn Research make an interesting product, I believe, which helps to bind these heavy metals and pull them out of the body. But chlorella is another interesting thing that you can take. There's heavy metal movers. There's many different types of things that help to pull metal from the body. Hair analysis is a very interesting way to determine heavy metal contamination, because hair is an excretory tissue, so it's dead and it grows out of the body. The follicles bathe in blood, so it's going to pull out. If there's any mercury circulating in the bloodstream, it will come out of the hair. So I'd recommend you do a hair analysis to look at the relationship of all of the metals in the body, including copper and zinc, which, as you pointed out, can very much be affected through this pathway. So there's definitely an affinity with copper, zinc, and mercury through metallothionein protein. So I'm not going to go too much into metallothionein, but they actually compete with mercury in the bloodstream, zinc and copper, particularly zinc. So zinc elevation in the hair can occur. And you may think, oh my God, I got too much zinc in my body. Well, you haven't. In fact, you've got a deficiency, because mercury is binding to this metallothionein protein, stopping zinc from docking into it and getting into the cell. So in fact, you've got a zinc deficiency. If mercury is elevated in the hair and zinc's elevated in the hair, you've got a zinc deficiency. That's the first thing I recommend that you do, right? I learned that trick from Dr. David Quigg from Doctors Data in Chicago, who's the heavy metal expert. So always check copper, zinc when you check mercury. Hair analysis, and you can work through Doctors Data Labs is a really good one. There's many different good laboratories that do hair analysis. You can also do urinary provocation, but I'm not a fan of that. It made me pretty sick when I did that years ago. Hair is quite an interesting one to do. So what I recommend first is an assessment. What would have been smart for you to do is a hair analysis prior to getting the amalgam work done. Hair tests are only like $100. So you could have had one done prior, during, and then well after. And what you would have noticed is this. You would have noticed that mercury was at a set level, and then it increased as the mercury work is being done, and then it should come down, in fact, become very low. So then you've got the test pre-work and the test post-work to see. And obviously the test you do well down the track should be much, much lower, you know, than the one that you had before the amalgam removal. That gives you a good ability of confidence to know that you've removed much of this toxic metal from the body. I've got no doubt that there's a relationship with mercury and candida. I've seen this in myself. I had 13 fillings removed about 30 years ago now. It made a big difference in my life. But it did take 1 to 2 years to get on top. because back then when I had the amalgams removed way back in the 80s, doctors didn't have a clue what they were doing. There was no rubber dam used. They were removed in weird sequence, and I got very sick after that. So I would recommend rubber dam only, and then be careful. They can actually check the electrical reading of each tooth, the negative electrical reading, and the worst tooth should come out first, the worst filling, etc., up to the one with the least amount of galvanic offence in the body. So you need to see a dentist who's very sharp and on the button when it comes to mercury removal. Many mercury dentists are not really as clued up as they should be. What else can I say? So Supro is a dumb thing, getting the Supro, because that can really wreck the gut. So you probably will need to be on some good probiotics to help to build up the gut health. I would recommend, if you're serious and you're spending this kind of money on fillings, is to get a stool test done. Hair test and stool test. And then try and repair the gut first, get it to a good level of health before you go on and looking at mercury detoxification. It's not good if you've got a digestive system in poor health to look at detox, because you're going to reabsorb a lot of those toxins again. You need to have very good excretory pathways through the liver and through the kidneys, especially. The kidneys, Dr. Quigg used to tell me the kidneys cop it very bad with mercury. Arsenic and cadmium in particular hammer the kidneys, but mercury can make the kidneys very sick as well. So you need to have a kind of a kidney cleansing detoxification going on there at the same time. What else can I say? So I would get the gut fixed up first before I recommend that you get into the detox, basically. That's what I would recommend. So I hope that answers your question, Jeff Durham. Thanks for the question.